Talk about harvesting honey. We like to use bee escape. These are sometimes called a Quebec bee escape. And to use those, we put them underneath our stacks of honey. This yard, we're harvesting honey just once at the end of the year. It's early October now, 2nd of October, and we're getting the year's crop off the hives. Sometimes we harvest honey in the middle of the summer and at the end of the year. Just happen to be doing it this at the end of the year this time around. So we got to get all these supers off to be able to get this bee escape underneath them and then put all the supers back on again. It's a lot of effort getting them back off and on. And so what we do is use this little stand here and tip the supers back onto the stand, put our bee escape on and tip it back on. The hardest part is right at the beginning, prying this big heavy stack up. So we use a real heavy duty hive tool, because there's a lot of force there, and a weaker hive tool will just bend and not force the boxes up. We'll get started there. We make sure we use a good bit of smoke on the hives because we're banging them around a bit. Smoke the neighboring hives as well. And then it's good to have a second hive tool handy so you can be able to pry at both sides of the box at once. So we'll just tap that into place, so we can get a good bit of leverage on there. And then we'll tap the one in on the other side. And then what we're gonna do is just pry up and loose the box. There, it cracked free and we're ready to tip it. So we come around to the back of the hive. So we'll just tip it back right onto this stand. Sometimes it slides a little bit, but we just ease it down. There's a tremendous amount of weight there. But we just ease that down onto the stand. And then we have full access down to the brood chamber and the queen excluder here. I like to just leave the queen excluder in place when we put on a bee escape. So we'll set it on there. And then we can tip the staff back onto it. We line it up so that it's lined up well and the corner is going to hit down right there. And then we just tip the box forward. All the way up. And then forward there. As you can see, it's not right in place, but it's a pretty simple matter using your hive tool and a bit of force to be able to pry that back into position. Sometimes we get a few less pries than that, but that we've got it back into position now. The only thing left to do is to check and make sure there are no holes where the bees could get in and rob when the other bees move down through the bee escape. So we use painter's tape to seal up any little holes that might be present there. We leave that on for 2 days. This time of year the nights are cooler. That's partly why those supers stick together so well, because the wax is really kind of set and is rigid. But 2 nights when the nights are cooler like this is adequate time for the bees to clear out of those boxes, so we can come back and take them back with us. So it saved a lot of prying and a lot of lifting by just tipping it back and putting it back on. Now we're going to show you what we do with smaller stacks and what we sometimes do in the summer to save some effort with handling the boxes. So here we have a hive that didn't do quite as well. I think it was a later split. I can't remember, but it's only got 2 boxes of honey. So each of these weigh as much as 60 pounds each when they're full. Just guessing, we'll say they're 50 pounds each. That's 100 pounds there that we're having to handle to take off. The one that we just tipped over, that's 5 boxes, so that's about 250 pounds that we're handling in that way. But periodically through the summer, we're opening up hives, maybe going down to the brood chamber. So you can use these stands for that purpose or for harvesting honey in the summer when they're not so well stuck together. So we'll just pry that off. Pry it up. And we just, in this case, just stand the supers off like that. So we haven't had to bend down to the ground to set it down, and we're able to just slide them off and put them on. This time of year, the wax and propolis are really well things shut, so it is tough to be prying them apart there. But now we'll just take a bee escape, put it in place, and again, we're not having to bend over too far or strain ourselves, and just slide that over into place. That is right full, as is this one, and slide that over. Put the lid on and we're done. We'll come back in a couple days to take that honey off there. So you can see how handy a little $30 device like this is in harvesting honey. Thanks very much for watching. See you another time.